Now we'll move on to the next concept, which is the concept of equation of a chord. Equation of a chord joining points phi and theta. When I say points phi and theta, they are called the eccentric angles. These are called the eccentric angles. By the way, guys, all of you are familiar. What are these eccentric angles? If not, let me quickly tell you that. So let's say this is a ellipse. Eccentric angle is basically when you draw a circle. When you draw a circle, this angle that you make from the line connecting the origin to any point on it, this angle is called the eccentric angle. Okay. And when you drop this down on the ellipse, then this point will have coordinates a cos theta comma b sin theta. Please note that it is not the line connecting the center to any point. It is first it goes till the circle and from there you drop down. So that point eccentric angle will be theta. So theta is not the angle between the line connecting the origin directly with the ellipse. So first it goes and hits this circle, which we call as the auxiliary circle. This is called the auxiliary circle. And from the auxiliary circle, let's say it hits the auxiliary circle at B, then from B, at A, and from A, we drop a perpendicular down to hit the ellipse at P. So P will be A cos theta, comma B sin theta. Okay. Now my question here was, if you have an ellipse like this, what's the equation of the chord connecting any two points having the eccentric angle phi and theta? Okay. So what's the equation of this chord? Let me name it as AB. So equation of the chord AB. It's very simple. You know two points, correct? When you know two points, you can always find out the slope of the line connecting those two points. And you can use the slope point form. So guys, I will just save your time in this and I'll quickly discuss with you the result. I'm sure you can always find this out by using the slope point form of the equation of a line. So please note down the equation of the chord connecting two eccentric points theta and phi. So this is the equation of the chord. Right. So remember, when your theta tends to phi or phi tends to theta, when theta tends to phi or phi tends to theta, it becomes x by a cos theta or x by a cos phi plus y by b sine phi is equal to 1. So this is actually the equation of the tangent or the parametric equation of the tangent drawn at phi. Anyways, we are going to talk about it separately in terms of tangents. Why I gave you this equation of the chord is because there's a very important question that comes associated with the equation of a chord. The question goes like this. If a focal chord joining two eccentric points, let's say phi1 and phi2. Two eccentric points, phi1 and phi2, passes through AE comma 0. Okay. Then prove that tan of phi1 by 2 into tan of phi2 by 2 is E minus 1 by E plus 1. Okay. And if it passes through minus E comma 0, then prove that tan phi 1 by 2 tan phi 2 by 2 is equal to e minus e plus 1 by e minus 1. Any one of them, if you can prove, that's fine. No need to prove both of them. Please type done in your chat box if you're done with it so that I can start the discussion with it. All right, so it should not be of much problem to you. Let's say I want to prove the first one. So I know the equation of the chord connecting two eccentric points, phi 1 and phi 2, is x by a cos phi 1 plus phi 2 by 2 plus y by b sine phi 1 plus phi 2 by 2 equal to cos phi 1 minus phi 2 by 2, right? Now it's also given in the question that it passes through ae comma 0. So substitute x as ae and y as 0. So you get e cos phi 1 by phi 2 by 2 is equal to cos phi 1 minus phi 2 by 2. So e by 1 is equal to cos phi 1 minus phi 2 by 2 by cos phi 1 plus phi 2 by 2. Let's apply componendo and dividendo. That means let's do e plus 1 by, e minus 1 by e minus 1 by e plus 1. It means you have to subtract the denominator from here, that is phi 1 plus phi 2 by 2, and in the denominator you have to add them both. Right? Yeah, so we will get e minus 1 by e plus 1, as this term will actually become 2 sine this by 2, which is phi 1 by 2 into sine phi 2 by 2. And in the denominator, you'll get 2 cos phi 1 by 2 cos phi 2 by 2. So 2 and 2 gets cancelled, leaving you with tan phi 1 by 2 into tan phi 2 by 2. Okay, great. So you can similarly prove the second one as well. Right? Hope it's clear. No doubt with respect to it. If you have any doubt, please feel free to type it in the chat box. All right. Next concept that we are going to talk about is position of a point with respect to an ellipse. Position of a point with respect to an ellipse. So let's say I have an ellipse like this. Now a point x1, y1. Could be at position A, B, or C. That means it can be within A, within the ellipse. That means at position A, on the ellipse, that is position B, or outside the ellipse, that is position C. Okay. So when we say x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1, please remember this. This expression is actually called the expression S for an ellipse, just like we had it in case of a circle and parabola. Similarly, when you substitute a point in place of x1, that is called s1, the normal notation that we use. So this is called the power of the point with respect to an ellipse. So if the power of the point is negative, that means the point is located at position B. And if this is positive, then we say the point is located at C. Okay. Nothing very great about this concept. So we can move on. Next is intersection of a line and an ellipse. Intersection, you realize more or less the same concepts are repeated. Intersection of a line and an ellipse. So let's say we have a line and an ellipse. Line is basically the y equal to mx plus c form. And ellipse is, let's say, our standard case Okay. X square by a square plus y square equal to y square by b square equal to 1. Now, a line and an ellipse, a line and an ellipse can interact with each other in various ways. It can either cut or it can touch or it cannot even touch. Okay, so let's call this situation as situation A, B, and C. Okay, so when do you think the situation A will arise? So situation A will arise when you directly solve these two, when you simultaneously solve these two equations, equation number 1 and 2, right, you will get two real and distinct roots, right? So when you substitute y is equal to mx plus c, you get something like this. Okay. And when you simplify this, I am directly going to write the quadratic that you are going to get. You are getting going to get a square m square plus b square x square plus 2mc a square x plus c square a square minus a square b square equal to 0. So when you simplify this, this is the quadratic that you're going to get in x. So for it to have a real and distinct roots, its discriminant should be greater than 0. That is your b square, that is 4m square c square a to the power 4 should be greater than 4ac. Okay. I think you can directly drop the factor of a square and 4. So 4 and a square will be dropped. So you get m square, a square, m square, c square is greater than a square, m square, c square minus a square, m square, b square. Okay, plus b square c square minus b to the power 4. So these two will be cancelled off. That means b to the power 4 plus a square m square b square is greater than b square c square. Okay, so drop the factor of b square again. So it becomes c square is less than a square m square plus b square. All right. So this is the condition for A to happen. That means the line y equal to x is cutting the ellipse. So without wasting much time, we can say when c square is equal to a square m square, the line will be touching the ellipse. This is situation number A. This is your situation number B. So it is touching the ellipse, touches the ellipse, or it is a tangent to the ellipse. Okay. And when your c square is greater than a square m square plus b square, it is going to not touch the ellipse at all. Please note that these conditions are very much specific to the standard case of an ellipse. So as the ellipse changes, these conditions will also undergo a change. Of all these conditions, situation number B is important to us, which we call as the condition of tangency, which we call as the condition of tangency for any line y equal to mx plus c to touch x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. So we'll talk a little bit more about it. So condition of tangency. Is c square is equal to a square m square plus b square, which actually implies c can be plus minus under root a square m square plus b square. In other words, you can also write the equation of a tangent. You can also write the equation of a tangent as y equal to mx plus c. In place of c, you can actually replace this. So that means if you're given the slope and the equation of the ellipse, you can always write down the equation of the two tangents as follows. So this form is also called the slope form of the equation of the tangent. This form is called the slope form of the equation of the tangent. Okay. And it's very important to also note the point of contact, the point of contact where these tangents will touch the ellipse. The point of contacts can be remembered by a very simple formula: a square m plus minus a square m by c plus minus b square by c plus minus b square by c. Right, where your c is actually this expression. C is actually under root a square m square plus b square. So this is the point of contact. Please remember this. It just saves time for you. All right. Of course, we'll be talking about other form of ellipses, other form of tangents as well. But meanwhile, I would like to take up a question on this. The question is, if x cos alpha plus y sine alpha equal to p touches the standard form of an ellipse, then prove that a square cos square alpha plus b square sine square alpha is equal to p square. So please do this question and type done on your chat box once you are done. It's a super simple question. All right, so done. Great. So it's quite simple. You first write it in the form of y equal to mx plus c. So it becomes y is equal to mx. So it becomes minus x cot alpha plus p cosec alpha. Okay. So we can use the condition for tangency. That is c square is equal to a square m square plus b square. So c square, which is going to be this, is equal to a square m square, which is going to be cot square alpha plus b square, and you multiply throughout with sine square. That's going to give you a square cos square alpha plus b square sine square alpha, right? Hence proved. Okay, very simple question to start with.